Over the last month, as the stock market has caught fire, we've seen some unlikely strength in the biotech space. Now, you often don't get the biotechs roaring at the same time as you get the industrials and the financials, but maybe they should never have been down so much in the first place. Still, if the biotech stocks are exploding higher, what does that mean for the more tangential plays? Something like Charles River Laboratories. It's a contract research organization that provides universities and biopharma companies with the tools they need to discover new drugs and conduct clinical trials, right down to the purpose-bred lab rats used in safety studies. They're basically an arms dealer to the drug business. While Charles River's been a terrific long-term performer, more than doubling over the last 5 years, you know we like the stock. Stock's come under pressure of late. Since it peaked at 149 in April, it's fallen to 132 today. Latest setback, a weaker forecast than expected, given how flush the client base is. So what does this stock need to do to get back on track? Let's get a closer look with Jim Foster. He's the chairman, president, CEO of Charles River Laboratories International. Been there a long time. Knows the business, get a better sense of how this company's doing, where it's headed. Mr. Foster, welcome back to Mad Money.
Nice to be here, Jim.
Okay, so Jim, you and I both know the industry's incredibly strong. So what I'm trying to do is say, you know what? This is my whole thesis when I was working on it this weekend. I got to get people into Charles River Labs when the stock is down while the business is great. But there is a bit of a disconnect. And the disconnect, frankly, I thought you explained well. But there is a disconnect between the forecast that you gave and what we thought you were going to do. So maybe you can just throw some meat on those bones and then we can deal with how well things are.
Sure. Our business is not linear. We talk about that all the time. Right. People don't start studies and stop studies congruent with our fiscal quarters. But we're really thrilled with our long-term growth rates and our current growth rates. We've been growing at high single digits. We actually grew at high single digits in the third quarter, almost 8%. We were pleased with that. We're quite pleased with our guidance that's out there for the year. And in fact, we said that for the next couple of years, 2 to 5 years, we'll grow the business at high single digits, and we'll get our operating margins into the over 20%. So we're pleased with the demand curve. We're pleased with the performance of all three of our segments. And frankly, I think that our forecast was perhaps slightly a little optimistic, but for the year, we'll be in great shape.
Okay, so let's talk about what people then, some of the more critical analysts then indicate, that perhaps there are indications of a slowdown, that biotech funding has peaked, that it's downhill from here. You've got many years worth of biotech dollars in the system that need to get to Charles River in order to be able to get something to market, don't we?
You know, the better the funding is, the more concerned people are about it for some reason. So this year, the funding is up dramatically. It'll be comparable to last year, which was the second highest year in biotech funding history. We figure there's about 3 to 4 years of cash available to them from the capital markets, probably the same amount of money flowing into biotech from the pharmaceutical companies as the biotech companies have become the discovery engines. So we have never seen a better demand curve, which is why we worked on 85% of the drugs that were approved last year, and which is why we continue to add to our portfolio through M&A to be a more expansive solution for our clients. So biotech is strong. The majority of our revenue now is coming from biotech, both large and small.
You have to, it seems like, expand pretty much everywhere you are. I noticed that Wayne, Pennsylvania, got a big new facility. I didn't think that you would need that quickly. Is that just to meet demand?
Yeah, I mean, demand, as I said, is very good. So we've been adding capacity across most of our businesses slightly ahead of when we need it. We obviously don't want to have too much capacity. Right. By the same token, we want to have enough capacity to take on work when we get it. So we will do that at multiple sites. We're doing it at multiple sites this year, and we'll continue to do that in the future as well.
There's an amazing moment in your conference call where people are talking about the competition in China. And you say, first of all, we only have a 30% share. I thought that was funny because most people don't have 30% of anything. But that you say that the quality of the product from the competition is inferior. Now, I'm used to hearing that the Chinese are better at us and better than they are at everything that we are. And that maybe that we are a second class, a pitiful, helpless giant. And the Chinese know far more about everything.
You know, the research model business is a very complex business. We've been doing it for over 70 years. People trivialize. They think it's easy to produce research models. There's an extraordinary amount of know-how, genetic oversight, animal husbandry, and veterinary medicine. So we've been able to, apply our almost eight decades of know-how and really set the world standard. And if you want to do high-quality research anywhere in the world and have peer review success, you really want to use Charles River animals to discover and develop that drug. And so these mostly government companies have tried to chase us, and they've just been simply unable to do it from a biological point of view, and lots of them have gone belly up. So we're going to continue to build new facilities and grow geographically throughout China, which is obviously a huge market, and pretty much set the standard of excellence in that country so that new biotech companies and growing pharma companies will utilize our services.
Well, one last question. It looks like from right at the opening that you guys are talking about remarkable drugs that are to come, that we are about to enter a new era where it sounds like there's going to be a lot of illnesses that will be cured using Charles River.
I think this is one of the most extraordinary inflection points in the history of drug development. We have a whole bunch of new modalities, from immunotherapies to cell and gene therapy, which is the latest and greatest, monoclonal antibodies, messenger RNA, and we are both treating and curing diseases which used to be often fatal and often very, very serious. So it's a wonderful time to be servicing an industry which with such high growth, and we have a whole host of clients that are utilizing Charles River, and I believe we'll continue to do so.
Well, thank you so much, Jim. It's always great to hear from you. Also give me a lot of hope that things are better than we think. That's Jim Foster, Chairman, President, and CEO of Charles River Labs. You very rarely get a chance to buy the stock when it's down from the high. This is it. Stay with Cramer.